Welcome to Vedic Mathematics Basis Base Values classes. We are continuing with our initiation and exposure to the values and features of 5-space VMST. In phase 11, we are at lesson 66, the final lesson of this phase. In this phase, the focus is going to be the bridging the gaps as augmented text, and the workshop focus of this workshop 6 is going to be upon the different generic counts of the points range and the gaps of the points range. The group activity focus is going to be upon the 1000 names of Lord Shiva. In the previous workshop, our group activity focus has been upon Panch Avaran. So from Panch Avaran, which is a scripture of 189 shlokas of 7th Samhita, chapter 31, and we know this value 189 takes us to 9 into 21, and 21 is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6, which is parallel to Sthapatya Mairing Rod. Further, we had seen that the Akash Tattva is of the TCV value 29. It was 8 plus 21. Now, 8 into 21 gives us 168, and we know that 168 are the primes, total primes of the range 1 to 1000. So up till 1000, the total primes are 168, and the Akash Tattva is, on the one hand, takes us to value 29, which is parallel to the formulation Brahma, the presiding deity of the creators of space, and on the other hand, the 8 multiplied 21 takes us to 1000 values prime. The total primes of 1000 values, 1000 are the branches of a Samved. The ultimate reach of the diamond format or of the grid is when we are having say feature of alpha letters, alpha numerals, then here the double digit number is going to be alpha into alpha, and alpha square goes out of it, and it is this feature that alpha square goes out of it is the feature which makes it that when the alpha would be 1000, then when we will be having a 1000 place value or say 999 value, even then the square of the same is to go out of it. Therefore, the format here is to remain of a triple digit number like this, where 0 would be a place value system. So from these features, we know that the Vedic systems are chasing the whole range of values in a grid format, and this grid format n cross n is transited further, transformed into n minus 1 and n plus 1 grid, which means dimension and domain relationship. And this value n minus 1 into n plus 1 gives us a value n square minus 1, so it is 1 less than the value of a square. Therefore, the grid accommodates the whole range of double digit numbers, but 1 less than the square value. It is this feature that it should be 1 less than the square value, which is to be within it, and the square value is to go out. So the triple digit numbers will be, the first triple digit number is going to be 100. So the even if when we will be taking that, we are having a numerals, say 999 numerals, then 1000 place value, when we'll be working out, then we'll see that it will be accommodated here, and there will be no need for taking to 1001th branch. This branch is no more there. The whole branches get exhausted up till 1000. Therefore, the value 1000 is the choiced value, and we know The Sahastra is a formulation which is of TC value 23, and Anant, infinite infinity is Anant, which has no ant, ant, when there is no end. For that as well, the TCV value is 23. And we know 23 is equal to 5 plus 3 plus 5 into 3. It is the superimposition of the addition and multiplication of the dimension and domain features. All these features at work, and these are at work in the organization of Shiv Sahasranam Stotram. Shiv Sahasranam Stotram is the ultimate transcendental values reservoir. This scripture is in Koti Rudra Sahita. We know Rudra is of value 17. Koti is of value 30. And when this value Ka is a Ka Brahma, it takes us to value 16. Therefore, this value 13 transits and transforms into value 16, and it is like 16 sutras and getting of the range of these 16 Ganita Up Sutras. These all are the features which are at work in the organization of the Shiv Sahasranam Stotram. This Shiv Sahasranam Stotram is a part of a Koti Rudra Sahita. Koti Rudra Sahita is the fourth Sahita of Shiv Puran. In this fourth Samhita, Shiv Sahasranam Stotram is a complete scripture. Shiv Sahasranam Stotram means 1000 transcendental names of Lord Shiva, transcendental Lord. These names are recited by Lord Vishnu. We know that Lord Vishnu is lively within the cavity of the heart of transcendental Lord, and further within the cavity of the Lord of Shiva is the seat of Lord Vishnu, and within the cavity of heart of Lord Vishnu is the seat of Lord Shiva. It is this phenomenon which deserves to be imbibed well. And we know it is 2 plus 3 is 5, 2 into 3 is 6. This also we know, that 6 points range is having 6 points range is having 5 gaps. Therefore, the counts as 6 and gaps as 5 give us different generic. Therefore, the generics are having different counts, gaps are having different counts, and the points themselves are having different counts. Both these 6 plus 5 make a summation value of 11, and this is equal to the 11 versions of hypercube 5, which are the representative regular bodies of 5 space. So 5 space is the 11 geometries range, and the 11 versions of hypercube 5, the 11 versions of hypercube 5 are the representative regular bodies of 5 space, and 13 geometries of the 6 space, the self-referral domain, are the representative regular bodies of 6 space. So 6 space geometries are 13 in number. There are 13 versions of 6 space. Therefore, 6 space is of a 13 geometries range parallel to 13 versions. And the 5 space is having the 11 versions. So 5 space is of 11 versions, and these are 11 geometries range. Now see, the 5 space is presided by Lord Shiv, and 6 space is presided by Lord Vishnu. Now this Shiv Sahasranam Stotram is being recited by Vishnu. It is being recited by the Vishnu, and this recitation is as a Maheshwar. So Lord Vishnu is visiting approaching Lord Shiva as Maheshwar. And Maheshwar is a formulation which is of TCV value 39. And 39 is a value which is of 3 into 13. As such, the 13 value, so it is within the creator's space, the whole phenomenon is happening within a creator's space. And within creator's space, we know that 12 edged cube, the solid, it manifests a 13th edge, a edge which manifests along the degree of freedom, and it reaches up till the transcendental origin. Transcendental origin is of a solid dimensional frame. Therefore, Vishnu, the overlord of six space with 13 versions and 13 geometries range, is the setup with four space in the role of the dimension of a six space. And within four space, 13 edged cube is, the 12 edged cube is manifesting the 13th edge, and 13th edge has a reach up till the transcendental origin, and this transcendental origin of a solid order. As such, here the value 13 into 3 is 39, and it is the value of a Maheshwar. Lord Vishnu, the overlord of six space, is approaching transcendental Lord as a solid order origin of the creator's space. Solid origin of three dimension, the role of a three space in the role of a dimension of five space, playing the role of an origin of a four space. And within four space, we know that the hypercube 13, hypercube 12 is manifesting the 13th edge. Further also, we know that the four space with five space as an origin is leading to a phenomenon where the five space transcends out. Five space as origin transcends out, and the spatial order format of four space splits four space into a pair of dimension, leading to value 13. All these phenomena are happening simultaneously. All these phenomena are being chased. These are being formulated, and these are being formulated as a Shiv Sahasranam Stotram. The Shiv Sahasranam Stotram is a scripture of 132 shlokas, and it gives us a value 11 into 12. Means the whole scripture is a scripture of 11 multiplied by 12. We know that 6 space is A raised to power 6 is to 12, B raised to power 5. 6 space is self-referral domain, is enveloped by transcendental boundary of 12 components. These 12 components, so this role of 5 space as a boundary of a 12 components, and 5 space itself being of 11 versions. Therefore, these 11 versions and these 12 components. So 12 components of the transcendental boundary of 6 space, 12 components of the transcendental boundary of 12 space, and each component has a 5 space being of 11 versions. So it gives us a value 132. It is this 132 values. These are 132 versions of 5 space. Hypercube 5 as a 5 space content in the role of the transcendental boundary of 6 space is making a setup of 11 into 12 is equal to 132 versions of 5 space content lumps. So 5 space content, the Akash Tattva, the fifth element with its space content itself, is being chased here in this particular scripture as of 132 versions. Of these two 132 versions, one version, the last version, the complete version, when there is only a 5 space without any boundary, this particular last version with respect to the last boundary component. So last boundary component with its last version as such is going to be a distinct version, and it is a version which is the version of a reach at the self-referral origin. Therefore, reach at the self-referral origin is a one shloka, and there are remaining 131 shlokas. Now let us see the formula, this value 1, 3 and 1. And we know 3 is equal to 1 into 1, the synthesis value of the pair of linear dimension is 3. Therefore, at the middle, therefore as a dimonad with its joint as a pair of linear dimensions having a reach towards it, it giving us a value 3, here is a value 1, here is a value 1. Therefore, actually it is along 131 shlokas, shloka 2 to shloka 132 are the shlokas along which the 1000 names, transcendental names, transcendental designations of Lord Shiva are being organized here. This is the first feature. With this first feature of the organization of Shiv Sahasranam Stotram, we will be sequentially reaching at whole range of infinite transcendental values will unfold from within this scripture. These 1000 transcendental names of transcendental Lord Shiva are the transcendental formulations which are availing the format of the transcendental boundary of a self-referral domain of 12 components, and each component itself being of 11 versions parallel to the 11 versions of hypercube 5, and with it sequentially it is unfolding from within. It is this sequential unfoldment from within which is to be chased. We have to initiate ourselves, we have to expose ourselves, we have to prepare ourselves for absorbing the values of these 1000 names. Now these 1000 names, which begins the first name Shiv, second is Hara, third is Mrid, fourth is Rudra, fifth is Pushkar, and sixth is Pushpalochan. We will reach at the transcendental code values of each of these. So first letter will give us a value 12, second will give us a value 14, third will give us a value 19, fourth will give us the value 17, fifth will give us the value 8 and 6, 14 and 16 and 4, 20, and it will give us a value Pushpalochan, which is going to be the value 8, 14, 20, 25, 32, 34, 35, 43, and 44. Like that, we have to reach at the transcendental code values of whole range of 1000 names. And thereafter, in terms of these transcendental code values, will be reaching at the geometric formats beneath. So these are TCV values with the geometric format, which will be taking us to value 20, and the initial value 12 as Shiva is going to be a raised to power 6 is to 12, b raised to power 5. So the format for the first name will take us to the transcendental boundary of 12 components. Like that, beginning with the first name, and we will reach at Sarv Tattva Alamban, the last name, the 1000th name of is Sarv Tattva Alamban. This Sarv Tattva Alamban is the end reach value of these 1000 transcendental names. Therefore, we as a group activity, we have to collectively recite these names so that each name gets printed in our memory. Once each name is printed within our memory, then our intelligence field will go transcendental within a creative boundary. So this transcendental intelligence within the creative boundary would be the achievement of imbibing of the values of these 1000 transcendental names. Now this imbibing, thereafter as a collective activity, we will reach at the total organization features of this scripture. This total 1000 names scripture with a anant, infinitely infinite features, is going to be the our reservoir, going to be our asset, going to be our achievement. And it is this achievement when we will be further reaching at in the sequential organization, that once we organize, say, these names, going to be, say, first name is of two syllables, is of value 12. Like that we will reach the whole range of the values. And further, the second way to organize would be that these transcendental code values, which are going to be of a beginning with the value 5. Therefore, the first name, Yash, is the transcendental name, which is of a transcendental code value 5. Therefore, the transcendental code values accepted by these 1000 transcendental names is having the least value, the first value, the first transcendental code value is 5. So we will begin with 5 and reach up till 89. Therefore, this range of TCV values will make a 5 space VMST format for us. Aim is that we shall reach at a 5 space VMST format. This 5 space VMST format would be reached firstly by imbibing the transcendental values of these 1000 names in the sequence in which these are organized. So our group activity, we as a group of 5 sadhakas, so each group of 5 sadhakas shall collectively recite these 1000 names, and in this exercise of collective recitation, we will be, each would be helped by others, and there would be a collective wisdom, collective values coming into play, and with it all these names, first to the last name, from Shiva to Sarva Tattva Alamban, from Shiva to Sarva Tattva Alamban, this whole range of 1000 transcendental names with their parallel transcendental values will be imbibed in by our consciousness field. Therefore, moment the sadhaka will absorb these transcendental values, then the intelligence field will get a consciousness base. The intelligence field with the transcendental values enveloped within a creative boundary, creative envelope. So within the creative envelope, the transcendental field will be becoming the basis base of the intelligence values. With this, when these values would be reorganized in the sequential format of beginning with the first TCV value 5 of formulation Yash. 5 is the TCV value, it is the first TCV value, it is the minimum TCV value, and with this minimum TCV value and this minimum TCV value itself as well is of a frequency 1. Then the value 6, the next TCV value 6 is of frequency 2. Then the third TCV value 7 is of frequency 3. One may have a pause here and take note that these frequencies are leading to the another sequential organization feature of 5 space VMST. And we know that the basic formulation, the ultimate formulation is going to be of achievement of the transcendental domain for reach at its self-referral origin. So for a reach at the self-referral origin, this complete scripture, the full mantra is Om Namaha Shivaya. And this formulation, Om Namah Shivaya, is of syllable 1, syllable 2, and syllable 3. And we know that values 1, 2, and 3 is a unique triple value of whole numbers. 1, 2, and 3 is a unique triple. And this uniqueness of this triple is having a unique ultimate transcendental key. The ultimate transcendental key of the existence phenomenon within our solar universe, which takes us to the Brahman domain, it is within the triple values as a set. The first triple values 1, 2, 3, which lead to Om Namah Shivaya. So the basis-based mathematics, basis-based geometry, basis-based values of the discipline, of the scripture, of the mantra, Om Namah Shivaya, is parallel to the triple values 1, 2, and 3. We know the importance of this 1, 2, and 3 triple for the whole range of whole numbers and ultimately of entire set of numbers. So whole number theory and everything about the numbers, Sankhya, is going to be unfolded in a triple 1, 2, and 3. And this takes us to Om Namah Shivaya. Like that, sadhakas have to imbibe each and every feature. Each and every feature of the Sahasranam Stotram is to be imbibed for it. The initiation is to be, the activity is to be, the exposure is to be at the initial stages as a group recitation. So sadhakas form the groups. 5 sadhakas form a single group. One group of 5 sadhakas simultaneously recite. These complement and supplement each other. The entire activities of the workshop, as well as of learning, and as well as of the exposure, as well as of the evaluation, and in fact of the entire initiation and exposure program, is going to be a collective, a group effort of a group of 5 sadhakas. In this way, when we will be in a position that we have as a group activity imbibed and are face to face with the organization format, features and values of Panch Avaran of 189 shlokas, which is equal to 9 multiplied by 21, which means 9, a Brahm, a 9 space is being translated along a sthapatya miring rod synthesized by hypercubes 1 to 6. 6 space plays the role of a dimension for 9 space as the origin. So this reach is the reach of Panchavaran. Panchavaran in fact is a 5 folds. These are the 5 folds of the creative boundary. 5 folds of the creative boundary of the transcendental domain. So once we are sequentially face to face with the existence phenomenon, the transcendental phenomenon, the creation phenomenon within each of the 5 folds of the creative boundary of the transcendental domain, then the Panch Avaran will, as is the inherent promise in it, as is the inherent insurance in it, as is the inherent blessing in it, that the intelligence field once is going to be face to face with the values livingly within the Panch Avaran, then the one would be blessed and one would be entitled with the bliss and grace of a transcendental grace order. After that, the 4 as an applied value, so the pure values imbibed by being face to face with the values living within the Panchavaran. One will be going for the applied values, and applied values format is the format of the values or transcendental values of 1000 transcendental names. 1000 transcendental names values are to be availed as the applied values. So these 1000 transcendental names, values and features make the 5-space VMSE format for the chase of the applied values of the existence phenomenon of our solar universe, maybe within frames or maybe without frames, including within the human frame. The pure values are to be faced, pure values are to be imbibed as are livingly within Panchavaran. So the Panchavaran is a pure values reservoir with which we have to be face to face, and this 189 value, 9 into 21 value, 9 into multiplied by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 addition as a Sthapatya Meiring rod. So the Sthapatya Meiring rod format when is to be availed for a reach at 9 space as an origin with 6 space as a dimension, then we will be blissfully happy that we are face to face with the ultimate Brahman reservoir of the pure values of the transcendental domain. Then for the applied values, we have to go to the Asht Prakriti. That means we will be availing the Asht Prakriti, eightfold nature, eight space is flowing along a Sthapatya Meiring rod. So 6 space as dimension will be taking us to 8 space as a domain. It will be giving us a dimensional frame. Our 8 space is having a dimensional frame of 8 self-referral dimension. Each of the self-referral dimension is of the format of a Sthapatya Meiring rod of value 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6, making it value 21, and 8 such dimensions make a value 8 into 21, which is going to be 168. And this value 168 is parallel to 168 primes range of values range 1 to 1000. Therefore, the entire primes range of 1000 values are at work in the applied values of format created livelily available for each of the sadhakas in the transcendental values of 1000 transcendental names of Lord Shiva. Therefore, these pure failed values and these applied values go parallel, and they take us from 8 space to 9 space and reverse also from 9 space to 8 space as values 8 and 9. We know off of the organization 2 raised to power 3 and 3 raised to power 2. These are vertically reflection pair. Therefore, with this reflection pair, this vertical reflection pair, we will be ultimately in the transcendental cyclic phenomenon, which will be working of its own, and these inherent potentialities of this system, once we are on this format, then we would be automatically on the translation path of the transcendental carriers being carried by the transcendental Lord along the Sthapatya Meiring rod presided by Lord Vishnu, with Mayur presided by Lord Brahma. With these, from the next phase, we'll be entering a phase when our workshop activities will transit and transform into model demonstrations. So in next phase, in phase 12, we'll be taking up the another more blissful aspects of 5-space VMST as is preserved as an ancient wisdom in Shri Purana. Thank you very much.